you don't have to turn on me, but in Revelations chapter 20, verse 14 through 15. And death and hell were cast into the lake of fire. This is the second death. And whosoever was not found written in the book of life was cast into the lake of fire.
My God.
Jesus. On October 17, 2009, I was walking down the street, me and my brother, on our way to the store. My mom asked me to get a box of cereal, so we was all walking on the way there. And all of a sudden, a car was going out of control, and it couldn't stop. So the brakes, I guess, they went out, and all of a sudden, it hit me and my brother. And they were both laying on the ground, and that was the last thing I remember. So now I'm in this dark place, and I've never really been in this place before. And I'm looking around, and I don't see my brother. I don't see the car that hit me. I don't even see the sun outside. It's just pitch black. So now I'm like pacing the floor, and I'm trying to see what's going on. And I'm like, okay, let me think back. I was walking my brother, and then this car came, and then I was in blank. So where am I? Why am I in this place? It's so dark and it's so lonely. Let me try and see something I see familiar. As I started pacing the floor, I see a bright light. Okay, let me walk towards the light. Okay, so I start walking to the light, and I get close, and I see it's an angel. Okay, I remember my mom telling me about angels and stuff in church. So I go to the angel, and I say, where am I? And she said, you're at the gate of heaven. I say, okay, angel, how do I get in this place? She said, your name must be in the book of life. Okay, my name is Alexis Story. It should be in there, right? She starts to turn the page like I'm not in there. And now I'm getting a little nervous because I know my name should be in there. If I gotta get to heaven, my name gotta be in the book. Okay, check the back. Story. My name will always be in the back of the book. My name is not in the book. Okay, now I'm scared. And my heart is pumping, and I start to feel an evil presence getting a little closer to me. Okay, ma'am, please, what do I gotta do? What do I gotta do? And she continues to shake her head, and as she shakes her head, the evil spirit gets closer. He gets closer and closer to me, and I'm pleading to her. I'm pleading, and she just keeps saying no. Your name is not in the book. There's nothing I can do for you. You should have thought about that before. So now I'm scared, and an evil presence put up on me. And as the evil presence got closer, the angel started to leave. The evil spirit came closer, and the angel left. And I was just seeing the evil spirit, and I'm in this dark place again. Okay. So now he tries to grab me. He grabs my arm. He grabs my arm, and he starts to drag me.
Thank you.
did a great job of just showing how it's gonna be, but imagine being in a fire that can't be quenched, being in a place where you cannot escape. This is the time to ask for forgiveness.
Come on.
You know, I know we gonna move on, but now this is something I really take serious. When I saw that thing on YouTube, I started to cry. And I said, Lord, if I'm not living right, if I'm not in a place where I should be, please, Lord, do not let me go to hell because of what I did. Now let me go to hell because I was mad at my mother, because I was mad at my father, because I didn't get that job I asked you to give me, Lord.
Come on.
So God told me that night, he said, ask for forgiveness. And I'll forgive you for your sins. He said, humble yourself before me again, and you will never see the face of the devil. You'll never see the enemy. You'll never go to hell. You'll never burn in a fire where water would not be able to wash it off. So now's the time. If you're not living right, ask God to forgive you right now. If you did something on last week you know you shouldn't have been doing, ask God for forgiveness right now. If you know you should be doing more in church, ask God for forgiveness right now. I know you died on the cross with me for a reason. And now I believe in you again. And if you said that, you're a born again believer. And God wipe your slate clean. And keep the angels that camp around you. And when you want to go left or right, the Holy Spirit will lead you the right way.